Let's give our dancers and singers a round of applause, everybody. All right, at this time, we're going to excuse our dancers for now. We're going to give them a break. That was a long lap. It's a big arbor from experience. It's a big arbor. This past powwow, I carried the flags on Saturday, and they made me go around backwards, sideways, and man, my legs were feeling it for 3 or 4 days later. I couldn't walk. Never felt so out of shape. All right, I guess we'll start ladies first, as normal. So I guess we can start with our traditional dancers. All right. So in usual demonstration, we go through all the different categories. We give a verbal kind of explanation of our categories and what's kind of been taught to the person who's talking. So the words I'm saying and the things that I'm explaining are what was taught to me, and it's not exactly what's right and wrong and in stone. This is what has been passed on to me verbally on the history of the different categories, and there's a variation of different categories. This is our women's traditional. It's more of a stationary dance, more of not as much movement in that case. They still move, just not as much as other dancers. The story I was told is when the warriors were coming back from battle in Dakota way, all the women would line up along each side and kind of give these men's traditional dancers a lane to dance down as they come back to camp. And so as you can tell, when they dance, they stand there with pride. They have their hands up. They step with pride because they're proud of their husbands or their family members who made it back from war. So singers, whenever you're ready, let's give these women's traditional an awesome song. Give our women's traditional a round of applause, everybody. Thank you very much, singers. Thank you, Sioux Valley singers, for that awesome song. Next, we're going to call out our men's traditional. So we're going to bounce back and forth between women and men and kind of demonstrate on either end. So if our men's traditional dancer can come on out, we'll get Dakota Hotine to sing him a nice traditional song that he can get Wakuchina for. The history of our men's traditional is pretty self-explanatory. As he's dancing, he's going to be telling a story about what has happened if he was in battle, when he was in battle. So Ahana, back in the day, they would retell their story, right, either through a shake-up or a sneak-up song or even a straight song. They'll get nice and low like they're searching, you know, searching for the enemy or searching for tracks. And as the song goes, they'll be up and they'll pick up the pace, and then they kind of mimic what has happened. So they're telling their story. So almost every traditional dancer that I watch kind of has their own story, and they tell it as well as they can. And that's what we have today, is we have a history in Sioux Valley of a lot of champion traditional dancers and late champion dancers. And I take pride in that personally. I spread that to every powwow I go to remind a lot of our Sioux Valley dancers and to remember who they are, because they're worth remembering. Right? A lot of them paved the way for us to be able to do these things we're doing now. And that's the best part of why they did what they did. So whenever you're ready, Dakota Hotine, let's give our men's traditional a smooth song. Take it away. Let's give our men's traditional dancer a round of applause. Thank you, Dakota Hotine, for that smooth song. It's a big arbor. It's a lot of area to cover. All right, next up, let's get our women's jingle to come on out. getting our songs sorted out and our drums. The story behind our women's jingle dress can go towards more of our Anishinaabe people out in the East, and it's more of a healing dress, right? There's a lot of stories that come along with it, and a lot of story has been told. And myself, I'm not as knowledgeable in women's jingle, and I'll own up to that. So all I know is about it, it's a healing dress. So when you hear the cones and you hear the dress, it's supposed to make you feel good inside and kind of heal you as you're watching. We'll give these jingle dress dancers 2 push-ups. So not a full song, we'll do 2 push-ups. So singers, whenever you're ready, let's give our jingle dress dancers something to move to. Give our jingle dressers a round of applause. Jingle dress dancers. Jingle dress. Thank you very much. That is a big area to cover. I can't emphasize that enough. As I'm looking across over there, that stand is pretty far. All right, switching to our male categories, let's go to our men's grass. We have a few in this category. Dakota Hotane, you can get your song ready. We'll give these grass dancers 2 push-ups as well. So 2 push-ups, we don't gotta worry about 4. Story of the grass dance is pretty self-explanatory. The grass dance is mimicking the grass, the movement, the long, tall grass of the plains as it moves in the wind. Same with the grass dancers and the long fringe that they have. And as they move, what has been taught is what you do on one side, you mirror it, and you do on the other side. So there's this kind of a certain rules and kind of unwritten rules that kind of came with the dancing styles that you were taught when we were younger. And those have a little bit changed since then, but there's a lot of people that carry on those old same ways. And we have some demonstrations, some future grass dancers here that are demonstrating for us that I convinced to come out and dance for all of you guys as well. So Dakota Hotane, whenever you're ready, take it away for our men's grass. Let's give our men's grass a round of applause, everybody. It's a lot of courage to stand up there and dance in front of a lot of people. Thank you, men's grass. Thank you, Dakota Hotane, for that awesome song. All right. Now we get into our fast categories. Let's get call our women's fancy, or our junior girls fancy. Thank you for coming. So our women's fancy category is more aimed towards mimicking a butterfly. A lot of our categories are mocking or mimicking an animal. And our old-style fancy dancer is going to show that they're going to be dancing like a butterfly, how random and how swift and fast that they move, and random throughout the arbor, right? They do quick, fast steps, just like when they're in the wind, they're floating all over the place as well. That same energy and then same beautiful charisma that's about them. That's what the women's fancy is mimicking. It's a graceful dance. It's very quiet, but it's very graceful. So singers, whenever you're ready, let's give our little fancy dancer something to move to. Let's give our fancy dancer a round of applause. Thank you for coming. That was awesome. All right. Now for our finale, our big ending. We have our men's fancy. At the end, we also had a request of our jingle dress dancers to do a sidestep, so that'll be after this is done. But currently, we're going to be doing our men's fancy. We're going to get Dakota Hotain to sing them a fast song. The fancy dancer, from my understanding and what has been taught to me, is the fancy dancers are mimicking a wild horse. So if you see a wild horse jumping and kicking and spinning and turning, that's kind of what we're mimicking. We're moving our shoulders a lot more. We're moving our feet. Right, we're looking more mimicking that wild horse style. When you get to further south into the more southern states of the United States, it is more of a battle mimic, just like a traditional dancer. They're out there more mimicking their battle, and it's called a war dance. Whereas here, it's a little more different, right? It's more youthful. So Dakota Hotain, whenever you're ready, let's get our fancy dancer moving. Let's give our men's fancy a round of applause. One more. Thank you, Dakota Hotain, for that fast song. All right, well, sneakily, before we conclude, our jingle dress dancers, as per request, we're going to get them to come on up to do a sidestep. This has been growing more common in modern society now with the sidesteps to come out kind of as a healing type song, as dance. They want to spread, you know, they take pride in the sidestep, and the Anishinaabe people have all these different contests when they go out to their areas and their celebrations, and they have sidestep contests. And you know, they judge on how well they do it, but here today they just want to show you guys and demonstrate and kind of give forth, you know, that good energy of being able to demonstrate a sidestep, and you guys can see it for a big day like today. So singers, we'll give them a couple push-ups, two push-ups of a sidestep, just to give them what they want, and we'll give them, they can give a show for our people here. So whenever you're ready, take it away, singers. Thank you, Jingle Dress Dancers. Let's give them a round of applause. That was an awesome demonstration. The joy in the youth is prevalent in that. All right, to wrap up our demonstration, we're going to get all of our dancers to come on in for an intertribal. We're going to get Dakota Hotain to sing one last song before we wrap everything up and just wrap up this demonstration and move on to the things that were planned after us. And I think we have a celebrity showing up after this in a bit here. Everybody's uncle, I think. All right, let's get all the dancers out into the arena. Find yourself some space. And Dakota Hotain, whenever you're ready, let's give them a final intertribal to wrap it up. Again, thank you everybody for coming and participating and giving us some time to demonstrate what we have. All right, Dakota Hotain, take it away.
Oh,
Let's give our dancers and singers a round of applause. Let's go. And this is going to conclude our demonstration, our powwow demonstration for this afternoon. And we just want to thank you for giving us the time of day and the time to come and present ourselves. So again, let's give our singers and dancers a big round of applause. It takes a lot to come out here. And I just want to say thank you to the singers. It takes a lot of knowledge and a lot of years to get to how it is now, where they know the songs and they can just sing like that. So to finally conclude, again, thank you for everything. Thank you for listening. Thank you again for giving us the time. Madakiwas.
Oh, thank you for that, Jason. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for all coming down to Weepazoka Wakpa 2023. We're going to be bringing the cup to you in about half an hour. So to fill in that space, I'd like to introduce the next entertainment for today. Without a further ado, I'd like to introduce to you, he's coming from all the way from Viva Las Vegas, the Ojibwe, Elvis Presley. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen.
CC Rider, oh, see what you have done. Well, I said, see, CC Rider, oh, see what you have done. Well, you made me love you now. Now your loving man is gone. Hear what I say. Well, I'm going away, baby, and I won't be back till fall, fall, fall. Well, I'm going away, baby, and I won't. If I find me a good girl, I won't be back at all. Hear what I say. going away, baby. And I won't hold it back till fall, fall, fall. Well, I'm going away, baby. And I won't be back till fall. If I find me a good girl, I won't be back at all. Hear what I say. Well, I should see you see right now. Well, I should see what you have done. Well, I should see you see right now. I'll see what you have done. Well, you made me love you now in loving man. Hear what I say. Well, I should see right. Well, I should see right. Well, I should see. I should see. I should see right. Well, I should see right. Well, I should see right. Well, I should see. Well, thank you very much. Well, you know I can't be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, then at least please telephone. Don't be cruel, do I? That's true. Well, baby, if I made you mad with something that I might have said, please, I do forget my past. My future looks bright ahead. I'm a cruel, too hot, it's true. Why should we be apart? I really, really love you, baby. I press with my heart. I don't stop thinking of me. Don't make me feel this way. Come on over here and love me. You know what I want you to say? I don't want to be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you. Look it up. Let's walk to the preacher and let us say I do. And then you'll know you'll have me, and I'll know that I'll have you. Don't want to be cruel. It's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you. Look it up. Don't be cruel. Do what? That's true. I don't be cruel. Do what? That's true. Here we go. Well, I don't want no other love. Baby, it's just you. Look it up. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you, sir. Way down in Louisiana, back in New Orleans, way back up in the woods among the evergreens, stood a log cabin made of earth and wood. Lived a country boy named Johnny B. Good, who never ever learned to read or write so well, but he could play the guitar just like a ringing a bell. Go, 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 Johnny, go, I said go. Go, Johnny, go, I said go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, I said go. Go, Johnny, go, I said go. Johnny B. Good. His mama told him one day you will be a man. You will be the leader of a big old band. Many people come from miles around. I hear you make your music when the sun go down. Maybe someday your name will be in light. Said Johnny, be good tonight. And I said, go, go, Johnny, go. I said, go, go, Johnny, go. I said, go, 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 Johnny, go. I said, go, go, Johnny, go. I said, go. Johnny be good. Here we go. His mama told him one day you will be a man. You will be a leader of a big old band. Many people come from miles around. Hear you make your music when the sun goes down. Maybe someday they will be in light. Say, Johnny, be good tonight. Then I said, go. Go, Johnny, go, said go. Go, Johnny, go, said go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, said go. Go, Johnny, go, said go. Hop, Johnny, be good. Thank you very much. How about a nice round of applause for the M-Funk Dance Studio dancers? You've got your powwow dancers, I've got mine, baby. Give them a call if you want to have some showgirls at one of your events. We certainly need them at this one. Zach, Whitecloud, congratulations from all of us.
Return to sender.
Return to sender. I gave a letter to the postman. He put it in his sack. But the very next morning, he brought my letter back. She wrote upon it.
Return to sender. Address unknown. No such number.
Where?
No such soul. We had a quarrel, a lover's fight.
All right, I'm sorry, but my letter keeps coming back. So when I dumped it in the mailbox, I sent a special deal. But the very next morning, my letter came back.
She wrote upon it.
Return to sender. Address unknown. No such person. Where?
No such soul.
This time I'm gonna take it myself and put it right in her hand. And if it comes back there next day, then I'll understand.
The writing on it. Address unknown. No such number.
Where?
No such soul. Return to sender. Return to sender. Return to sender.
We start singing those songs, we'll be here all night, boy. I tell you, good times here at Sioux Valley, Dakota Nation. Baby, let me be your loving teddy bear. Put a chain on my neck anywhere.
Oh, let it be
your teddy bear. Oh, I don't wanna be a tiger. The tigers play too rough. I don't wanna be a lion. Lions ain't the kind you love and love. I just wanna be your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck. Lead me anywhere. Oh, let me be.
Oh, let it be
your teddy bear. Here we go, baby. Baby, let me be around you every night. Run your fingers through my hair. Cuddle me real tight. Oh, let me be.
Oh, let it be.
Oh, I'm dirty, baby. Oh, baby, let me. Yeah. Cause I just play too rough. I don't want to be a lion. Lions ain't the kind you love and love. I just want to be your teddy bear. Put a chain around my neck. Lead me anywhere, oh, let me be.
Oh, let it be.
Your teddy bear. Oh, let me be.
Oh, let it be.
Your teddy bear. I just want to be your teddy bear. Thank you very much, darling. And who gets... How you doing? Oh, hey. And you, sir, you get the Walmart bag. Congratulations. Nothing but the best, baby. Losing my belt. Yeah. As a snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morn, another little baby child is born in the ghetto. That his mama cries, 'cause if there's one thing that she don't need, is another little hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto. People, don't you understand? The child needs a helping hand, but he's gonna be an angry young man someday. Take a look at you and me. Are we too blind to see? Or do we simply turn our heads and look the other way? Well, the world turns, and the hungry little boy with the running nose plays in the street as the cold wind blows in the ghetto. And his hunger burns. So he starts to roam the streets at night, and he learns how to steal, learns how to fight in the ghetto. Then one night in desperation, the young man breaks away, buys a gun, steals a car, tries to run, but he don't get far. And his mama cries. As a crowd gathers round, an angry young man face down in the street with a gun in his hand in the ghetto. And as her young man dies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, another little baby child is born in the ghetto. There his mama cries. Thank you very much, everybody. You're fantastic. Zach came from humble beginnings and ended up in one of the flashiest cities in on Turtle Island. And of course, that's Viva Las Vegas, baby. Here's one for Zach. Bright light city, gonna set my soul, gonna set my soul on fire. I got a whole lot of money that's ready to go. Go get those stakes up high. Let's go over here, honey. Baby bird, big in the fields. They were all there. Go with the speed. All you need is money and choice. Viva Las Vegas. Follow me.
Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas. They ride with 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't slip a minute away. Oh, the poker and the roulette wheel. Every deal. Mwah. Nerve to steal. Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas.
Flashing in your one of them. All those hopes are down the drain. We're running out. Viva Las Vegas, turn day into nighttime. Night into daytime. If you see it once, you'll never be the same again. I'm gonna keep on going. Have me some fun. Cost me my very last dime. If I find it broke, I'll always remember that I had a fleeting time. Oh, I'm gonna give it everything that I got. Lady Luck, please, nice to stay hot. Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas. Viva, viva Las Vegas. Thank you very much. Here you go, honey. Thank you very much. We'll just keep walking here till I collapse. It's good. How you doing, sir? All right. Beautiful. Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you kiss me once or twice? And then you run. Well, little sister, don't you do what your big sister does? Well, I dated your big sister, and you took her to the show. I went for some candy, along came Jim Danny, and they both snuck out the door. Little sister, don't you get this on camera. Sister, don't you kiss me once or twice. He's a nice man. Well, if sister, do what your big sister does. How you doing? Your sister, she's mean and she's evil like a little weevil. Guess I'll try my luck with you. Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you kiss me twice? Say it's very nice and then you run. Well, little sister, don't you do what your big sister done? I said, little sister, don't you do what your big sister done? I said, little sister, don't you do what your big sister done? Up! Another nice round of applause for the M-Funk dancers. Thank you, ladies. I think I got two more songs and then collapse. The doctor put me on Ozempic and now I'm skinnier than ever. You ain't nothing but a res dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a res dog, snagging all the time. Well, you even snag my auntie, you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a res dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a res dog, crying all the time. Well, you even snag my granny, you ain't no friend of mine. Just kidding. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't ever caught a rabbit, you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, moving across the floor. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't ever caught a rabbit. You ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but an old res dog. Thank you very much. I think this is another sad song on a happy time. And so this will be our second last song. Then we got to go and make way for Zach and his close friend, the Stanley Cup. Today I stumble from my bed, the thunder crashing in my head, my pillow still wet from last night's tears. And as I think of giving up, A voice inside my coffee cup kept crying out, ringing in my ears. Don't cry, Daddy. How about a nice round of applause for my backup band? Our children always first feel the pain and hurt the worst. It's cruel somehow. Just not right. 'Cause every time I cry, I know it hurts my little baby. So I wonder, will it be the same tonight? Don't cry, Daddy. Daddy, please don't cry. Don't. Daddy, you still got me and little Tommy. Together we'll find a brand new mommy. Daddy, Daddy, please laugh again. Daddy, ride us on your back again. Oh, Daddy, please don't cry. I'm crying. Oh, Daddy, please. Please don't cry. Yeah. Thank you very much. This is going to be our last song, and then we'll make room for the moment we've all been waiting for. Where's Elvis? Oh, birthday girl. Where's our birthday girl? A very old friend came by today. He was telling everyone in town about love that you just found, and Marie's the name of his latest flame. He talked and talked, and I heard him say that she had the longest, blondest hair, prettiest green eyes anywhere, and Marie's the name of his latest flame. Though I smiled, the tears inside were burning. I wished him luck, and then he said goodbye. He was gone, but still his words kept returning. What more was there for me to do but cry? Would you believe that last one, that chin is sweaty, that you just found. Don't burn me with that thing. Come here, baby. Mwah. Though I smiled, his tears inside were burning. I wished him luck, and then he said goodbye. He was gone, but still his words kept returning. What more was there for me to do but cry? Would you believe that yesterday this girl was in my arms and swore to me she'd be mine eternally, and Marie's the name of his latest flame. Oh, Marie's the name of his latest flame. Oh, Marie's the name of his latest flame. Thank you very much. That's my show. Another nice round of applause for the M-Funk dance troupe. Elvis has left the arbor. Now, if you want pictures, we'll come around and we'll take some pictures with you if you'd like. But coming up next, the proudest moment of one of my appearances is when we present the Stanley Cup here at Sioux Valley Dakota Nation, along with
your very own Zach Whitecloud. Jimmy Gwitch, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together one more time for Mr. Elvis Presley, all the way from Viva Las Vegas. Put your hands together if you've been to Viva Las Vegas. Has anyone here been to Vegas and watched the Golden Knights? Oh, like two people? I see somebody waving his hand over there. I was just notified they think the cup is in the valley. So we're just going to be sitting real cool like at the Arbor here. We'll give it a couple minutes, but he's going to be coming in through the main entrance over there where you all came in. He's going to be coming in with a wagon, a horse wagon too, pulling him with a cup. Side note, elders, if you guys are starving in the stands, you guys can go over there to the community gazebo. They're handing out hot dogs, chips, pop, elders first, and then everybody else can follow right after. So ladies and gentlemen, I want you guys to keep your eyes over towards that direction. Shout at me if you see him coming this way, and we'll start the show. Can I also have chief and council and our dignitaries, can you guys come up to the front arbor, please? I'll have you guys sit up here in these chairs so we can prep for the Stanley Cup. Thank you.
So they'll sing first, they'll sing their honor song for Zach, and then you guys can sing your guys' song.
Would you be able to sing
victory song? You guys will sing victory song?
still looking for my chief and counsel from Weepazokawakpa. I was also told to pull to grab Grand Chief Kathy Merrick. So Kathy Merrick, Grand Chief, can you come up here as well? As well as Regional Chief Cindy Woodhouse. Could Cindy Woodhouse, Regional Chief, come up here as well? So that's Kathy Merrick, Cindy Woodhouse. If you guys could come up here, that would be much appreciated. And our chief and council as well. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Good. Oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for player number two, Zach Whitecloud! And the Stanley Cup, ladies and gentlemen. Look at all the people around here today. Oh my God, thank you all for coming out, supporting Sioux Valley Dakota Nation. Thank you all for being here. But at this time, I want to start by opening it up in prayer. I asked my Unka Oswald McKay to pray for everyone on their travels home, and thank you all for coming here, but I'll let him take the mic over.
Oh, pidama kero takoja unka apetu. Oyukpe ed ohepe wa oyakape. Unka koshkala kan de taha. Hawashka te wa ichun yokpe ga you have money. Unka apetu kende. Ohia heche he dinaje. Oye oyo kupi kage ki ha ha ha. Onka e chunha ha atewa katanka unke unkikse apte. Ye taku hena was kage ki ha ha e echa. He hoyo kik ta unka nakun. Ohe dechi upu kihipsin ha hena ha wichawikse. Ohe chante shichap ki ha hena nakun. A peito que de wichawikse. O koshkala kande tokata ki a ohe. Woshka te chunke de yohamanik tonka. A te wa kantanka ye e de kichi tuikta. Ta kuek tashno a kacha ha hina pa khair kichi zika ha. Ha ta ku a manke ni ki ha. Wash agia heche tokata ki a. Ha di ha yok pe yushki a manik ta. E chin heche wa hino zicha. A to tiste ra heche a te wa kantanka. Ae hoi awa kikte. O ka ato wa kantaka apetu. O ashte chaka ed oyuk pe oyuske edun ka epe. Wiz bupa za ka wakpa oyate ke hechir ka wite. O ko dawe chonya pe enana tahan dechir ahia ta ka unka. O ko shkala ka on de tahan a washka te yuha mani yaichi. Ha apetu kin dechir uhiya ha dinanji. O he wupi don kinichi ape. Nie taako was hechi tu yakage. Oh, there was ye air, chahechin, mish, hawakachnege. O can't pay to kinde wokik, say a hanata. How I ate kinde, tapkapsi chapi ayape, a hana which has to have money pe. Oh, then I which howik, say. Anako re, upi chimash okihips na petu. Ure chante shi chapi hina which howik, say. Ate wa kantaka apetu kede kitana. O chante ki denana rike, yonkan ewicha hadikta. A ja he sher hoye chicha cha koskala ka petu trak in de kicho stikte ha tokata ki ha hechet hoska ti ha manikte a eta ja was agya yok pe yuske manikte do a ja hechet ato wa kanta ka hoye chicha cha ha chanko aste ha kicho ga a ja a wo pe da tanka e chiche do ho me takwe ken de nawas.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being here in Sioux Valley, Dakota Nation. There's a lot of you. Feel free to take photos with the Stanley Cup. From afar, though, just a side note, we have limited amount of time with the Stanley Cup, so then that's why we won't be taking individual photos, so you guys won't be able to come up and take photos with it close, so you'll have to take it from afar where you guys are at. But at this time, I'd like to call up Chief Jennifer Bone to say some opening comments on behalf of leadership in Weepazoka Wakpa. And then I'd like to ask Counselor Whitecloud to be on standby to be ready.
Good afternoon, friends and relatives. I just want to welcome you all here today and say welcome to Zach. We are all so proud of you. It's been such an exciting couple of months and seeing you playing in the playoffs and winning the Stanley Cup and now bringing it back to your home community of Weepazokawakpa. I just want to express how so very proud we are of you that you represent our Dakota Nations. I just want to welcome all of our visiting relatives and our neighboring communities that took the time to come out to our community today, and I want to express my sincere thank you to our staff for all of their planning to making sure that this historical event was a great one for Sioux Valley Dakota Nation, and it's turning out to be one so far. So I want to say thank you to everyone and wish you all a good day, and I hope you have a great afternoon. Thank you. Hamitakiwas.
Councillor Whitecloud, if you would like to share some opening comments.
It's an awesome day. I'm just getting loss of for words here. Like to thank you all for coming out. I know we've been all been anticipating this day for the past couple of months now, and it's finally arrived, and Zach has brought the cup back to Weepazokawakpa. I recall several years ago during similar honoring during one of our powwows, my kuda, Harold Blacksmith, had said, one of these days, he may bring the Stanley Cup here to Sioux Valley Dakota Nation. And it's happened. So unbelievable. When he was just a young boy, 4, 5, 6, he grew up playing with his cousins and relatives here in Sioux Valley. There was about 12 of them started out together playing, and they played at all the local arenas around the Sioux Valley here, and Oak Lake, even played in the arena in Alexander. I remember he played in Minto, Manitoba, just a tiny little community, and we played in that rink, Rivers, Hamiodash, Oak River, Kenton, Shoal Lake, Verdon, Elkhorn, all the surrounding towns here. That's where he started his career, so very come full circle for him to be able to come home, and at such a enormous occasion for him to come home with the Stanley Cup and present it to you people who have supported him 100%. I know, talked to many grandmas and grandpas, Kushis and Okans, who never watched hockey before Zach started playing in the NHL, and when they play in Las Vegas, they don't start the games till 9 o'clock our time here. So a lot of the grandmas and grandpas who have started watching hockey and started watching him play take their after supper naps so as they can stay up for the full 3 hours from 9 o'clock. And by midnight, they're going to bed. If it goes into overtime, then they're going to bed at 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning. And that's the same that goes for his grandma on his mother's side. She stays up late at night to watch him play, and you know, they're really big supporters, and I thank the elders. I think there's an elder stand here for their support. Again, thank you very much for the opening prayer, Oswald. Thank you to the singers for being here, Dakota Hotain and Riverside Dakota Wopida Gijijap. I'll let the festivities continue because he's here for a very short time. He's got lots of different places to stop this afternoon, so thank you very much. Wopida.
Washte, Pidamiado, Counselor. At this time, I'd like to call up Grand Chief Kathy Merrick. Oh, watch that drone. It almost took out one of our camera ladies over here. Kathy Merrick, if you'd like to say some opening words.
Oh, metakweapi is a word of our relatives here in Sioux Valley. I'm very honored to be here to represent the 62 First Nations of Manitoba, and that all 62 First Nations are very proud of you, Zach, and that we support you, and you sit here today with all the people that have come to be able to witness such an honor of you bringing the Stanley Cup to Sioux Valley, your home community. So we should all be so proud as we groom our young people to be good hockey players. And some of them make it to where he is today to be able to do what he's doing. And that that we be able to carry that with our people. And so with all the Anishinaabe, the Ojibwe, the Cree, the Dene, and the Dakota people, we wish you well on your journey, Zach, and that prayers be with you wherever you go, and that we're always going to be so proud of you, and we're proud of your family, your dad, for all the support that they have given you.
At this time, I'd like to call up the Regional Chief, Cindy Woodhouse, to say some opening comments.
Thank you, and congratulations to you, Zach. And I want to thank the drum group for the opening song and for our elders for starting us off in a good way. You know, Zach, many people pray for you. All, you know, and during the playoffs, all of us were that you'd be safe out there, because we know it's an intense game. And I want to congratulate your mom and dad, and as well as your entire family and this entire community for supporting you and for raising up such a strong athlete. And for all these young people here to watch this day, that you grew up on a First Nation and in a little town and skated in all these little rinks that, you know, my little boy who stands here with me, Colty Nipanak, that he goes to all those rinks, that you provide hope for our people, because sometimes it seems so hopeless. So on behalf of the Assembly of First Nations, we have 634 First Nations in this country. We are so proud of you, and thank you for giving us hope today. Miigwech.
Pidameado. I'd like to ask defenseman number two from Weepazoka Wakpa, Mr. Whitecloud, Zach Whitecloud, if you'd like to say some opening comments to the people, to all of our guests that came out. I'll bring the mic to you.
Kind of like my dad, there's not a lot of words. First and foremost, I'm going to keep it really short and simple. Thank you, everyone. I know a lot of you have traveled from far distances and have come out to support myself and my family and our community here. So thank you, everyone, for taking the time to come and celebrate, a dream of mine since I was a little kid. So everyone, travel safe, be well, and again, travel safe home when you head that direction. Thanks.
Pidameado. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together one more time for Mr. Whitecloud for bringing home the Stanley Cup to all of you. I'm going to ask the drum group Wakpa Iuicha to sing their victory song to honor Zach Whitecloud, bringing home the cup to the community. Pidamiado for the victory song. I'd like to ask the media in the middle of the arbor if you guys can please stand out of the way. We're trying to get everybody else from on the outside to take photos. There we go. There's the cup. I was wondering where it went. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, feel free to take photos of the cup, but please stand behind the fence in front of you. Elvis in your show, girls, can you please stand aside? You're in our shots over here. To our elders in the elders stand. Awesome, man.
Sometimes at night I can hear the ass crack. It sounds like thunder and it rips through my back. Sometimes in the morning, wow, I still hear the sound. Ice meets metal, can't you jam me down to the big league?
Yeah.
have here people who traveled as far as Ebenflow, Muskaugen, Cross Lake to see the Stanley Cup today. That's more than 10 hours away, ladies and gentlemen. So I want you guys from home to give them a round of applause to come support our community. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you, visitors. It's not every day we have the Stanley Cup in our backyard. Put your arms together, ladies and gentlemen! This is the first time in Vegas Knights history that they won the Grey Cup. It's definitely not going to be their last time. Oh, the Stanley Cup. Did I say Grey Cup? My bad. You guys can tell I don't watch sports clearly. We also have people watching from Facebook Live, YouTube Live, so I want to give a special shout out to you guys. Thank you guys for tuning in online. About 12 more minutes with the cup, it looks like. 12 more minutes. So maybe, Zach, if you wanna walk around the arbor one more time. One more time and we'll walk out the Stanley Cup. Media, side note, if you guys can please stand back a little for our home viewers and our visitors. Let them take photos now. all the kushis and unkas in this photo. Our grandmas and grandpas. Oh, what an awesome photo, man. Mr. DJ Man, can you please turn down the music? Sorry to say media, but they have to head on out. I asked them to come back, but they said they gotta go on to their next location. So, ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup has left the arbor. But for the short amount of time that it was here, awesome to see. Very inspiring, very motivating to see another community member, my family, to bring home the Stanley Cup in the NHL playoffs. Just goes to show everyone is capable of doing that. If you push yourself hard enough, you too, you can do impossible things. Thank you all for coming out today. Looks like you guys are all heading home shortly. But the two drum groups here, they're going to be singing a song for the cup going home. So if you guys are still around the arbor, please stand and remove your headgear if you can. And help us honor our relative. Honor the community. Bringing the Stanley Cup back. Wash day. Wash day. Ladies and gentlemen, a few more announcements before you all head on out. Go over to the community gazebo. You can help yourself. I think there's food there. Hot dog, pop, chips. I think they're ready over there. So go over to the community gazebo. But other than that, that concludes the Stanley Cup Bringing It Home Day celebration out here in Sioux Valley, Dakota Nation. Thank you all for coming out. I'd like to thank all of our guests coming from Ontario, coming from Saskatchewan. I'd like to thank the food vendors, the bouncy castles, all of the media production crews that came out. I'd like to thank the summer students as well for decorating the arbor and the band hall. I'd like to thank you guys in advance as well for tomorrow's cleanup. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, travel home safe. We're still going to be here until 3 o'clock. I have some games planned. So if you guys want to come play games, win some cash prizes, stay tuned. Stay at the Powwow Arbor. But for those who are leaving, thank you all for coming out. Travel safe. And we'll see you on the flip side.